And welcome back to our discussion on accounting, and we will discuss today on accounting for convertible bonds, and which is also called a method of accounting by the name of split accounting. So the focus of our discussion is split accounting, which is the accounting for convertible bonds. But before we do that, let us try to understand the various types of the financial, various types of instruments which the companies use to raise money, shares. Share is not a financial instrument under IS 32 and IS 39. So the treatment of shares is not same as the treatment of the bonds, debts and other financial instruments. But the relevant accounting issues are the treatment of dividend, treatment of bonus, treatment of buyback of shares. So that is one of the financial instrument. If a company issues non-convertible bonds, issued at par and redeemed at a premium, it can be any combination. A non-convertible bond is a financial instrument. So therefore, the accounting standard IAS 32 and 39 and the corresponding Indian accounting standards will be relevant for understanding the accounting for the non-convertible bonds. Since it is a financial instrument, the initial recognition will be at the fair value and the subsequent recognition is amortized cost. An amortized cost is determined using the effective rate of interest, and the changes in amortized cost will be shown in the income statement every year. The other relevant issues are the treatment of the premium on redemption, which most of the companies try to adjust that against the securities premium or charge it to the income statement. So adjustment to the securities premium, though it's not allowed under the IAS 32, it's more a practice in India, or charge in the income statement. Okay, income statement. The other related issue is of course the treatment of interest. So in a non-convertible bond, you have to find the amortized cost, the treatment of the premium and the treatment of interest are the relevant issues. Zero coupon bonds, because they are also financial instruments, most of the time the issues are more or less same. So the focus of our discussion today is a convertible bond. So convertible bond is also is a financial instrument. So therefore, the IAS 32 and wherever required, IAS 39 will become relevant for us. But the important feature of a convertible bond that on this date the bondholder has an option to convert the bonds into shares at a predetermined rate or at a predetermined ratio. So therefore, in a convertible bond, there are two different types of features of two different instruments are there. One is a debt, an obligation to pay interest and repay the principal. The other, an option to convert that bond into the equity. So the IAS 32 says, since it is a compound instrument having the features of both debt and equity, equity. There is a need to split on the date of the at the time of issue, initial recognition, into the debt and equity. But the questions are, what is the value of the debt? What is the value of the equity? What is the treatment of the changes in the value of the debt? And what is the value of the equity in the subsequent balance sheet date? And the treatment of conversion when the bonds are converted to equity? And just like the previous one, the treatment of the premium and the treatment of the interest. So these are the relevant accounting issues. But the important point under the convertible bonds is splitting the debt or splitting the bonds into debt instruments and equity instrument. So the value of the debt at the time of initial recognition is calculated by determining the present value of the bond payable plus the present value of the interest payable over the life. But this present value, computing the present value, the discount rate is the market rate of interest without the conversion option. So that means we try to discount or calculate the present value by using the interest rate or the coupon rate of a non-convertible bond as a surrogate for the interest rate. And the value of the equity will be, the total value of the convertible bond minus the value of the debt that which has been computed. So value of the debt, so value of the equity, value of the equity is a residual value. The change in the, and once you have calculated the debt, so the change in the value of the debt, since it is an amortized cost, will be shown in the income statement. But important point, you can see that the value of the equity in a subsequent date, since equity is not a financial instrument, no change in the value of the equity is recorded. Now let us take an example to understand that. Suppose the number of the bonds issued is 200,000. The face value of the bond is 1,000. The total value is therefore 200 million and redeemable at 1,000. The total value of the redemption is 200 million and the term is 4 years. Interest is 6% convertible into one share and the prevailing market rate of interest is 9%. And let us assume there is no expense or issue expenses. So on the initial recognition, the value of the bond is a present value of the bond at discounted at 9% and present value of interest discounted at 9%. So the total value of the bond is the debt component is the present value of the bond plus interest. And the balancing figure, that is 200 minus 180, 19.44, is the value of the equity. So the value of the convertible bond. So in the balance sheet, we will show equity. We'll show equity as 1944, and bonds as 188. So instead of showing the bonds as 200, but suppose there would have been an expense. If there would have been an expense, the expense would have been, all other things remaining same, suppose that an expense in million, okay, so expense for raising the bond is 1 million. In that case, the expense will be distributed between the bond value and equity value in the ratio of the value which we determined previously. So therefore, the value of the bond is 179 and 19.34 respectively. So to go back, so the value, so in case of a split accounting, the value of the convertible bond and the initial recognition is split between, is split into the debt and equity. For determining the debt, the present value of the bond and present value of the interest is determined, and to calculate that present value we use the market rate of interest without the conversion as the option, as the discount rate, and the value of the equity will be the balancing figure, so total fair value of the convertible bonds minus the value of the debt. Thank you very much.